Hello, everybody, and welcome to another awesome episode of PodPass. My name is Jordan, like always, and I'm here with brother Brandon.
Howdy do.
And best friend Ryan.
Hello, everybody.
And we wanted to talk about everything that we ate as kids growing up. Candy, cereal, drinks, anything you can think of. And that's why you downloaded this episode. However, though, before we do that segment, we have a beginning segment here. That's a first for us. We're going to do a blind beer tasting test challenge. I don't know what you want to call it. Beer tasting test.
All the things to correlate with the episode. All the things we drank as kids.
Yes. Yeah. We all drank these as children. But so we will be talking about everything that you guys have downloaded this episode to listen to. But we're going to do this as a fun little segment beforehand. So the reason why I wanted to give history to all the listeners out there and why I'm doing this. I am a simple beer guy. I like to call it the big three. I like the big three. Bud Light, Miller Light, Natty Light.
Ooh, right? That's one of the big three?
It is. I'll actually... Well, Coors Light's in there too, but
like,
Natty Light.
What's the criteria to make it a big three?
I'm going to explain.
Okay, sorry.
I have that
Jump
stuff.
Jump the gun, I apologize.
Yeah, I have that stuff. So, you know what? I misspoke with the Natty because, I don't know why I meant Coors, but... Bud Light, Miller Light, Coors Light, and Natty's in there too, of course. So, to me, I just like beer. You can give me a Guinness, I'll drink it. You give me a Corona, I'll drink it. You give me a Natty Daddy, I'll drink it. Beer's beer to me. However, though, and I don't want to misspeak on this, but Brother Brandon and Best Friend Ryan choose not to believe that. They don't believe that at all. So we had a big heated discussion last week about it before we recorded our show. So I decided to go out and buy 6 different beers, all under $6 of these cheap aluminum cans. Now I'm gonna tell everybody what the beers are. So, but how we're gonna do this is that each guy has 6 cups in front of them with a little bit of beer in each one. At the bottom of every cup is a number that's associated with the cans that we have here in front of us. So they're going to taste each beer, smell the beer, do a taste, whatever they want to do, to have their description of it. Is this good? Is it not? Whatever they want to do. And at the end of the taste test, they get to guess on which one is what and see if my theory is right that this kind of beer is just good old-fashioned taste, the same beer. So what we have to drink tonight is a regular Budweiser. Okay, then we have, which they didn't have Natural Light in the Big Bertha. I don't know why, but they have Natty Daddy.
What is Natty Daddy?
Natty Daddy's 8% alcohol.
Oh, wow.
God. All right, and this is the big one can. Now we got all the way from our friends up north, we have Labatt Blue, which is Labatt Ice at a 5.6% alcohol.
I'm surprised you didn't get Steel Reserve in one of these.
I was going to get it because it was 75 cents.
Oh, God.
We also have Coors Light, we have Miller Light, and we have Bud Light. Now, I know that you guys are not going to like some of these beers, but you will allow, if you guess which one you want, for example, if Ryan, you taste a Miller Light, and at the end of the show you say, that's a Miller Light, you're allowed to keep that beer if you want. If not, I'm just going to throw them away because they're open now, and I'm not going to drive home in containers. But... I'm going to be controversial for a second before we start, and this is not at all to be disrespectful. It's not the intention. It really isn't. But I found this article today, and this is what kind of gave me the idea to do this.
Okay.
Now, what I mean is controversial to you guys, okay? So at the bottom of my heart, I'm not trying to be a douchebag, and if I am, I do apologize. But because of our conversation last night, I found this article, well, a conversation last week, I found this article, and I classify you guys as a beer snob.
Okay.
And the definition of a beer snob is, a beer snob is a person who only drinks Belgians, IPAs, or Imperial Stouts, and believes that it is beneath them to drink anything else. And laughs to himself or herself when they see someone order anything but a micro.
A micro?
Yeah. Now, the reason why I say this is because we have pretty good average American beers in front of us besides Labatt, and Brandon is drinking a beer from Microbrewery.
Yeah.
Great Lakes Brewery. Now, tell me that's not a good...
I wouldn't say that's a good... I mean, a lot of it does apply, but I don't... I personally, I don't know about Brandon, I personally don't feel like drinking a Bud Light or a Coors Light or a Miller Light or a Budweiser.
And I've also never judged anyone who is rather...
It's beneath me. It's just, I would... I'm a social drinker.
No.
I don't drink to get drunk.
The person's not beneath you. Any beer is
beneath you. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm a social drinker. I don't drink to get drunk. I rarely drink to excess. I usually only drink when other people are drinking. So, in that scenario, I'm not going to waste my time with something I don't like.
Okay.
And I usually prefer
mm-hmm.
the Belgians and IPAs.
I'm just saying. I read it and I was like, oh, this is perfect. Do you not agree with this observation of the beer snob?
I mean, there. I do know of some people who treat their beer like a second child. You know, it's like they go to conventions.
Mm-hmm.
They're making their own beer in mm-hmm. their basement.
Who doesn't want to make their own beer, though?
But I don't know. I don't. I just. I enjoy, like Ryan, I enjoy taste, and I don't drink much either. So mm-hmm. even if I am drinking by myself at home, it's usually when I'm writing and I put down a couple just to get the edge off. And
okay.
then that's. But I'd rather spend a good $10 getting a 6-pack of my choice than to spend $7 on a 15-pack of
Natty.
That's going to put me on the toilet all night.
Sure. And again, before we continue on to the taste test, I just want to tell people, my side of this argument is that if you want to just do just American beers, this good old-fashioned, just normal beer, nothing special to it, beer's beer, it all tastes the same. That's the point of this. The last thing, and then we're going to go right here,
which
guys.
It's funny because in the beginning of your statement, you were just like, I'll take a Guinness, and you can like, just drink a Natty.
Well, no, it doesn't matter because to me, I mean, like, I mean, I just like beer. This is the last thing, and I'm done. This is this article came out last year. These are the top 20 most popular selling beers in America.
These things are going to get warm.
I know.
Be gross.
This is fast, just so you guys know. Number one is Bud Light. Number two is Coors Light, Budweiser, Miller Light, Corona Extra is number five. Natty Light is 6, Busch Light is 7, Michelob Ultra is 8, Busch Light is 9, Heineken is 10, Modelo
Especial.
Okay, that's 11, Keystone Light is 12, Miller High Life is 13, Natty Ice is 14, Bud Light Platinum is 15, PBR is 16, Bud Light Lime is 17, Bud Ice is 18, Yingling is 19, and Bud Light Limerita is 20.
Good God, that's a list of shit.
And the reason why I say that is because you got Aliens and you got Avatar, both directed by the same guy, right?
It's true. It
everybody loves Aliens, and a lot of people like Avatar. People would say that Aliens is a better movie than Avatar. Aliens would be your Guinness, your microbrews, your Belgians, your IPAs, your stouts. And Avatar would be your Bud Light. But it doesn't necessarily mean that it's bad. If a lot of people buy it and a lot of people think it's good, then it has to be good in some retrospect.
The two I only really, really love and put my money towards is Ambers or Stouts. But, I mean, still.
All right. So, here's cup one to cup six. Brother Brandon, best friend Ryan, pick up cup one. You guys can give a taste. You guys take a sip.
This is really warm. Is it warm?
It's warm. Yeah. Ugh. No, it's warm.
I knew this was happening.
Your intro was too fucking long, Jordan.
It was.
Yeah, that's harsh.
All right, so what do you guys think of that beer?
Warm, so it has a little spike to it.
Okay.
It's got that bitter taste, that like not good bitter taste.
Mm-hmm.
That most beers develop when they're warm. Cool. It does have the color and consistency of my urine from earlier this morning. And I'm going to say not my top choice.
All right. Brother Brandon, got anything on that one?
No, it's too warm to tell.
All right, let's go to number two, fellas.
Oh, I got to take a palate cleanser in between.
That one felt cold to me. Number two. No?
That is horrible.
That's horrible?
It is warm. It is a lighter flavor.
Oh, my God, that's bad.
Okay.
And then this
flavor.
One. I will agree that it does taste worse than the first one.
Yeah, that is much
so
worse.
Number two tastes worse than the first one.
Oh mm-hmm. my God.
I'm that assuming this is going to be the Natty.
There, that's what you're assuming?
The Natty Daddy.
All right, number three.
Oh God, I can't do this.
Yeah, I've never tasted this one before.
How's that one taste?
I think that one's Coors.
You think that one's Coors?
Is it Coors? Yeah.
Why do you think that one's Coors, Brandon?
I've had Coors many a time with you before, mm-hmm. and there's a particular taste to a Coors now that I know that I'm always distinctive of.
Okay. Here is number four. We got only two more left, boys.
Oh.
That one's bad?
I don't like that one.
No. You don't like that one at all, huh?
That's got a, like a, it hits you harder, I think.
Is it a darker color?
Yeah, it's a dark color.
Okay. Brother Brandon seems to enjoy it a little bit.
Well, I'm trying to, I got a feeling, because yes. there is a sharper taste to it,
mm-hmm.
and I'm almost wondering if that accounts for the 8% alcohol, so it might be the Natty Daddy.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Okay, so that was number five, okay? I'm sorry, number four. Number five, almost done, fellas.
I mean, they already don't taste the same to me.
They don't?
No. Like, there's a distinct difference between all of these.
Really? Okay. Maybe my taste buds are different.
Yeah, that's an average beer.
That's a Bud Light.
Yeah.
Just an average beer. Nothing about it. Okay, last cup for each guy. This is number six.
How long were you a smoker for? Like, how much did you smoke a day and for how long?
Well, I quit for a little bit, but let's just say overall on average, I was a smoker for 13 years, and I would smoke about a pack a day.
So your taste buds are kind of dull already.
Yeah, they're coming back. Number six. What do you guys feel about that one?
It tastes like kind of like water.
Tastes like water. So it didn't taste anything different than number five? Because that one you guys said tasted like a normal average beer.
I think this might...
Because you guys both said that actually, number five taste was like a Coors Light Bud Light.
Actually, now I might, just because of how this one tastes, this one might be the Bud Light, and the previous one might have been just a normal Budweiser.
Okay, so all together, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Brother Brandon, if you had to choose, which one do you think was the best or which one was the most tolerable for you to drink?
The one that had the most distinction was four. Because
number four.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't even remember.
Yeah, you guys can. Yeah.
And I only. It's because it's sharper, as I mentioned. Yeah. I think that might be because of the 8%. So that might be the Natty Daddy.
You're saying number four might be the Natty Daddy? But you like that one, though.
It's okay. I wouldn't. If I was already drunk and there was nothing else at a party I didn't want to be at,
mm-hmm.
I would drink it.
Mm-hmm. But what if you go to somebody's house and that's all they had was number four, which could be a Natty Daddy or cannot be? Would you take it right off the bat?
Can I just get a glass of water?
Okay. All right. So which one is the absolute worst for you, Brother Brandon?
Oh, man, the first two were...
The first two were bad.
It was a tie.
Okay, yeah. So...
I don't know if it was just a contributing to the warmth that was already in it.
Mm-hmm.
That probably... I don't know.
First two were just bad. Okay, so best friend Ryan, out of all the ones you've tried so far, which one do you think is the best or the most tolerable?
Most tolerable?
Yeah. Best or tolerable, whatever you want to call it.
Probably number five, maybe.
Well, this is fun for me. How about you guys? This is wonderful.
Yeah, I'll say number five. That one tastes like your average beer.
Number five tastes the best for you. So you both say number five tastes the best.
I would say four.
Oh, you said four. I'm sorry. Yeah. Now, which one is the absolute piss water shit
for it's either you? Two or three. I don't remember. I think it's three.
Natty Daddy. All right, so now, before we reveal, if you guys are wrong on any of these, could that possibly change your thought on just average beers where if somebody offers you a beer, like for example, if somebody offers you a Labatt Ice and you actually like that one, would that be an actual beer that you would drink now? Or would it be Guinness or nothing?
Well, all the ones I drank, I was never really like, fuck yeah, get me one of these. It's just like, okay, well that one's better subjectively than this one.
Mm-hmm.
Better than this one.
Okay.
So, I mean, it's not, if I'm wrong, it's not really going to change my opinion because
okay.
I'm still going to stick to the snobbish beers.
All right, so here's the reveal. We have Budweiser, Natty Daddy, Labatt Ice, Coors Light, Miller Lite, and Bud Light. Brother Brandon, which one do you think is number one, since you hated it the most? What do you think?
This part's really hard.
I know.
It was warm, so I'm gonna go Miller Lite.
You're going to go Miller Lite. Okay? Best friend Ryan, which one do you think number one is? This is going to be interesting to see because you guys did not like number one at all. Hated it.
I think I know what number three is for sure.
Okay. Do you still have beer number one? Let me see. Yeah.
I think I'm going to go with the...
Do you want to... Now, this bottle, if you want to feel, is cold. Do you want to take one more sip before you guys choose your opinion to see if that is it?
Could just look on the bottom.
It could. Because guess what? Number one is Coors Light.
Really?
Is it?
Yep. Do you want to take a sip of that? That's Coors Light.
Coors Light, when it's really cold, goes down real smooth.
That's Coors Light that you had. Now, you guys did not like it. You guys did not like that one at all. So, that's Coors Light.
Again, I think it's just the warmth of it.
Okay.
In the cup. I mean, tasting it now, it's... I mean, the big three that you named off, they're fine. They're serviceable. That's as far as I would go. Like, they're serviceable.
All right, so now, number two. Best friend Ryan, what do you think number two is?
Is that Labatt's?
You say that one's Labatt?
Is it a Labatt's? I'm going to say Labatt's.
You're going to say Labatt? Now, number two. Now, number one, which was the Coors Light, you guys were like, fuck that. Which is a very, very standard beer that you guys have drank in my house multiple times. So, look, that's gone. But you're saying Labatt... Hands down, number two, because that's the worst one as well, right?
No, I said number three, I think.
Number three was the worst, okay. So you're saying Labatt Ice. Brother Brandon.
I don't remember it now. I don't remember the taste. Oh, God.
What do you think that one is?
I picked Labatt's because I never had Labatt's, and that tastes different than...
You know why I picked ice beer?
Memory. I've never had an ice beer before.
And it's just because it has more alcohol.
Ah,
that's all it is.
That's why it's ice?
That's why it's ice. Mm. That's the only reason.
It's either Natty Daddy or Labatt Ice for sure.
Okay. All right.
I'm going to go Labatt as well.
Labatt? Okay, so you're both going to say Labatt. Okay. Miller Lite.
It was Miller Lite.
Miller Lite. Wow. Number two. Now, this is cold. You guys are more welcome to take as many sips as you want of any of this, but... Yeah.
Miller Lite.
Ooh, goodness.
We used to drink Miller Lite all the time.
My palate has changed, sir.
I guess so. All right, we're almost done, guys. Number three. Best friend, you said it was the worst, but Brother Brandon, we'll go with you first. Which one do you think number three is? We still got Bud Light.
I think
we got Labatt Ice, Natty, and Anheuser-Busch.
There was a distinction to it. I'm going to say Budweiser. It reminded me of.
I'm just going to ride that Labatt's ice until I'm right.
Okay. And you said that's the worst.
Three? Yeah.
Now, why is three the worst? What would you say?
It's kind of got that, like, sort of pungent backwash taste to it.
Okay. All right. You guys want another review?
It's also warm, too. Warm. So.
Yeah. All right. Labatt ice.
There you go. I'm not going to take a sip.
You're not going to take a sip on that one?
I got that one right, so I don't have to get confirmation.
Okay. All right. We're down to our final three. Anheuser-Busch, Bud Light, and Natty Daddy. What is number four?
I'm going with Natty Daddy, just because it was sharper and stronger.
Yeah, I'm going to say Natty Daddy.
Okay. Natty Daddy is correct.
Now, that's only because of the 8%.
Now, do you guys say that Natty Daddy is the best?
No.
Out of what you tasted?
Not to me. I think, what did I say, number two was it? Two was the best?
No, number two was Miller Lite.
I don't remember what I said was the best.
You know, it's not bad.
That's 8% alcohol.
And I think that's why. But, man. Out of all the choices, if anyone was going to offer me anything, I would probably drink the Natty Daddy.
So
and that's
far.
Only because okay. It would get me drunk quicker and I wouldn't have to talk to that person for the rest of the night.
Well, this is the last two. One is going to be selected and one is you guys going to know who is the winner.
Yeah,
so, which one is number five?
Bud. It's Budweiser.
Okay. And you say six is Bud Light?
Yeah.
What do you say, Brother Brandon?
Yeah, it's Bud Light.
I'll go the same route.
Okay. Budweiser's number 5 and Bud Light's number 6.
Yeah, yeah, if any of those, I'd be most apt to drink the Bud Light.
Out of all of them.
Yeah.
So, I already know the answer. I'm assuming my point has not been proven?
No, because they, to me, they have distinct difference in their tastes.
Really?
Each one, there was, even though I may not know where they went, what beer they went to, but you can tell the difference between each cup.
Really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Interesting, because to me, all this tastes generally in the, around the same ballpark.
And I, like, I don't want to be a dick or harp on anything, but I think it comes down to, like, I've never been a smoker. I don't know about Brandon.
No.
So, I mean, my taste buds aren't dulled.
The occasional cigar every once in a blue moon.
Yeah.
Blue moon.
It's a good beer.
So, that was our little test. I guess it didn't prove anything, but... Glass half full, half empty kind of guy. I just got brother Brandon and best friend Ryan to drink pretty cheap beer.
Yeah.
So it's a win in my category. I went out and spent my hard-earned dollars, all $6, and bought some cheap-ass beer, and I'm only going to drink a few.
How many blowjobs is that? One or two?
Well, if you're in Toledo, it's definitely 3.
There you go. Mm. Were they at least nice?
Mm-hmm. This Coors Light's good.
I feel like that natty. I feel like the Natty Daddy, if you're not careful with it, you're going to get fucked up off that.
Well, yeah, because it's 25 fluid ounces and it's 8% alcohol.
But it's such, the taste was, it's the only one, even going back to it when it was cold, it's the only one that has some sort of flavor to it. So I feel like, I don't know, your senses could get duped pretty easily. And before you know it, you're working on your third can, mm-hmm. and then you're kneeled over puking up your innards.
Blacked out, yeah. Yeah, the worst one that I tasted before, actually, I did not like Labatt. And I didn't like Natty Daddy because it's just too harsh.
Mm.
Too harsh.
I think that's why I gravitated towards it more, because there was a thicker, harsher taste to it than all the other ones.
Hmm.
And that's typically what I like in a stout. All
right. Yeah. Well, that was fun for me. So let's continue on with our show of food. So, best friend Ryan, you wanted to start up here?
Well, when I suggested the topic, I thought it was... we were doing like popular discontinued items, like stuff we remember from childhood that is no longer available,
mm-hmm.
and stuff like that. Not like just vague what we ate as kids.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, because I researched it. I did some research for this show, unlike any other episode. I spent the most amount of time on cereals. There are a lot of promotional tie-in cereals we were talking about earlier. I can get into those in a little bit, but that's a giant rabbit hole you can get lost down very quickly. I don't know if you guys have any ones that spring to mind of that
cereal.
No, just things that are popular foods that are foods you liked as a kid that you can't get for your kid.
Mine is a particular. Actually, I'm gonna jump into bubblegum. There's two bubblegums I got all the time in the little. It was called the Trading Post, which is just a little carryout in my hometown. Cheap-ass candy. You could walk out fucking $5 in a big-ass grocery bag full of candy. But the two things I remember was Ouch bubblegum, and it was like Band-Aid strips.
Yeah.
And then a tin can.
Yep.
And then I'm not remembering the full title, but I do know, I remember the advertisement for it. It was a jug of bubblegum.
The paint bubblegum?
It was like a miniature jug, and you opened up the top, and you could just, like...
Is it the powder?
I think so.
The powder bubblegum, I remember that. Because
I remember the advertisement.
I'll look up this name.
And the advertisement was always like, it killed me. Because I would use it on my mom. The advertisement before cartoons was like, sometimes you just need a jug of gum. And I went up to mom and was like, Mom, I just need a jug of gum. Come on, Mom. I just need a jug.
I don't see them making that stuff anymore. Every time I go to Kroger or wherever, it's all Orbitz or...
I mean, the big name companies.
Yeah, I don't ever see Bubblicious anymore. I don't see Fruit Strike gum.
Go to, and this is for listeners as well. I know people who are out of the country can't do this, but if you're in country, if you have a Family Dollar, or no, not Family, Family or Dollar Tree, that's right. That's the store where everything's a buck.
Mm-hmm.
Go to Dollar Tree. The candy there is fucking old and weird and out of date. And you'll come across a whole bunch of things where you're just like...
The candy that expired 10 years ago.
Right. You're just like, whoa, this exists now still? Like the Crybaby Tears?
Yeah.
You ever remember those?
I do.
Sour fucking chalk candies?
Mm-hmm. Ugh. I do remember
based off the Crybaby bubblegum. You never had the Crybaby?
I've never had Crybaby bubblegum.
It was this, it's just a little ball, and it's Warhead mixed with gum.
It's a Warhead? Okay.
Mixed with gum.
I've had Warhead gum before.
But this was before Warhead gum.
Okay.
This was this Warheads were cool when it was just an individual package and you would dare your friends because it was so hardcore, you know?
I remember those days.
Oh, no. Brandon and I fucked with each other all the time when we were kids with Warheads. We did. The blue raspberry killed us. No, the black cherry we hated.
I don't know. There's some YouTube videos of people that taking Warheads and putting it in other different candies. So, like, this one guy melted chocolate. He got a whole bunch of Hershey Kisses and melted it. And then covered a Warhead in Hershey and told his friend, oh, it's this new Hershey Kiss. And when he got through the chocolate layer, he got to the Warhead.
That's
just those cool challenges like that.
I do remember, which I don't think they sell them anymore because I haven't seen them in a while. I've not seen them do Oreo O's.
They have them at Walmart, I do believe, now.
Oh, do they?
They were discontinued for, like, over a decade.
That's what I'm saying.
I used to love those when I was a kid, too. That and Frosted Cheerios, and they discontinued both of them.
I was a big fan. The three cereals, I'm not going to say two, but the three cereals that I ate all the time as a kid. One was Cinnamon Toast Crunch, which they still have, which that's just amazing. But number two would be the Oreo O's, and then this one they still have now is the Reese's Puffs.
I love Reese's Puffs.
Those are always nice.
Okay, if we're going to switch to cereal real quick.
Yeah,
so
switch cereal real quick. Why not?
I found this website called MrBreakfast.com, and it has listings of all these cereals that have ever existed. At least that he could find, their little descriptions. So I found there was a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. That was a tie-in with the first movie from 1990. There was a Mr. T.
Yeah.
Branded cereal.
I've seen those pictures. The Mr. T is just little, not Cheerios, but the little, just like yellow balls.
They're corn puffs, but they're shaped like T's.
Thank you. Thank you.
And then they have little marshmallows in them that are shaped like Mohawks, the A-Team van, and then I think his feather, like his earring feather thing.
That's amazing.
Indiana Jones, I think that was a tie-in with the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull, though, so it's kind of on the edge of our time frame. Lion King. There was Timon and Pumbaa.
Do you remember what the descriptions are of all these? Because I want to know what Timon and Pumbaa would be like.
It's it was chocolate with marshmallows, and just it was bugs. They were shaped like worms.
Because Timon and Pumbaa ate bugs.
Well, it was called Mud and Bugs. This is what it was called. The cereal.
Mud and Bugs.
Mud and Bugs.
Mud and Bugs.
There was a Nintendo cereal system. It's like the Nintendo Entertainment System. It branched out into cereal.
Guess it was marshmallows as the characters.
No. It was. The concept was there was two bags inside. You can either choose Super Mario or you could choose Zelda. Super Mario was like fruit-flavored, sugar balls, and Zelda was berry-flavored.
That is a great idea. So I'm surprised they don't do it anymore, where you buy a box of cereal, and it's literally two cereals in one. You can have one side this flavor, one side that flavor. That's interesting. I don't know why they don't do that anymore.
They could do
like
that.
Nerds.
Nerds. Nerds on here.
Nerds cereal?
Nerds cereal.
Ugh. Has to be sour and...
Yeah.
What?
They're fruit flavored. They're all right. It's same concept. Two bags, different flavors. You can choose which one you want. Urkel O's.
Yep. I actually remember those.
I remember Urkel O's. I've never eaten them, but I remember them being advertised and them being in the store and stuff. Banana and watermelon flavored. The favorite
banana
one I found...
Watermelon.
The favorite one I found was...
That's a little racist.
That's very racist. Banana
and watermelon.
Might as well put some KFC in there. Jeez.
Okay, so there was a promotional tie-in for the film Prince of Thieves, which I didn't... Like, if you want to target all demographics, make a cereal, because that's where you get the kids and the
And Kevin Costner's the star.
Yeah, he's the star, yeah.
And it's Robin Hood.
He appeals to children. They've seen Bull Durham. Yeah. At that point, they've seen Dancing with the Wolves, little kids. So.
Field of Dreams?
Field of Dreams. It's a family movie. The thing I discovered about these is they were fruit-flavored, like corn puffs, and the actual cereal was shaped like arrows, because Robin Hood, he has
shoots his
arrow. But when you actually look at the pictures, they look like dicks.
Yeah, so literally kids were eating a bowl of dicks.
Eating a bowl of milky dicks. What
they're
doing.
Oh
such is
God.
Life.
Oh,
they're just teaching them. It's just teaching them life lessons.
Yeah, jeez.
There was, just to go through this real quick, found a Cabbage Patch Kids one. Captain Planet, though I couldn't find a picture of the box. This thing called Crunchy Stars, which I thought that this was also one of my favorite ones because it was Muppets branded.
Oh.
But it was only the Swedish chef.
Because it was because he's the chef. He makes food and cereal.
But I figured if you're gonna go put a Muppet mascot on a cereal box, you're gonna go with like Fonzo.
Fozzie Bear, Kermit, Miss Piggy.
Yeah, popular ones.
Yeah. But they went with the Swedish chef.
That was cinnamon flavored. There was a G.I. Joe, Star Shape. There's Ghostbusters.
Because eating your breakfast is just half the battle.
Jurassic Park, which I remember.
Oh, really? What kind was that?
It was Corn Puffs. Corn Puffs, dinosaur-shaped marshmallows.
So there is a lot of marshmallows in this.
Well, that's how you get the kids.
I mean, marshmallows don't taste good, right, guys?
No. Once you get them soggy and they kind of just dissolve in your mouth, that's what I enjoyed about them. And then there was a Tiny Toon Adventures that I remember, but not quite. I didn't remember it until I saw the box, and then I remember I watched the commercial for it on YouTube, and I remember the commercial. Then that reminded me of how like awesome our cartoons were as kids.
There's a YouTube channel. His name's Cinema Snob. Brad Jones is his real name. And there was one segment. He has one of his side segments is Brad Eats or Brad Tries or something. I forgot what it's called. But he actually got a box of Batman from the 89 movie Batman cereal. Never been opened. And then he tried a bowl. He said it's stale, old, tasted like 89. But it was there was actually Batman movie tie-in cereal. It was like, think of it almost like your, I think if I remember right, the cereal itself imitated that of like Captain Crunch. Those types of like peanut butter, like type squares.
Okay.
That's interesting. You don't see that much anymore. The only thing that I see recently in the past couple of years that they have brought back was the 80s and 90s Halloween ones.
Those are seasonal.
Those are seasonal, yeah. But you have Boo Berry, you had
Count
Chocula, and then what was the
Frankenberry?
Frankenberry, thank you.
There's a new one now, though, too. It's for the Wolfman. The Wolf O's, I think, something like that.
Why do they have a witch, I wonder?
I don't know.
Now, I actually have a box of cereal in my garage / bar at home. I kept the box, I ate it because I was so excited. When I bought it originally, and I cut the box, but the cereal actually was horrendous. And I bought it was Star Wars for the Force Awakens, and they came out with Yoda cereal, and then you could also have Kylo Ren cereal.
They had a C-3PO cereal back in the '80s when they were doing the like the Ewok cartoons and stuff.
And this was the same thing as you guys can think of it: cornflakes, whatever you want to call it, with lightsabers and starfighters, and it didn't look like any of them. Of course, at all. The lightsabers looked like a flashlight, you know, and stuff like that. So that's actually a good point that we can discuss, though, real quick. Why cereal? Just because kids love cereal? So if the kid buys the Robin Hood Prince of Thieves cereal, then he would want to go see a rated R Robin Hood movie with his parents. Because wasn't that R?
I think it's PG-13.
Well, it's still a PG-13 for a kid.
It's not a kid's movie.
No, it's not a kid's movie.
I think it's just an easy entry, right? That's kids eat cereal.
Because it's one of the quickest, easy meals for kids.
It's like, I mean, I remember when Batman and Robin came out, they were fucking all over Pop-Tarts. And I ate a shit ton of Pop-Tarts
because they were on
Batman and Robin.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not a huge fan of Pop-Tarts. I like two different kinds of Pop-Tarts and that's it. But I was eating, like, even the ones I don't like.
I like birthday cake Pop-Tarts.
Never had one. I like the brown sugar cinnamon and the chocolate fudge.
Gotcha. Now, question about Pop-Tarts, though. Do you actually put them in the toaster, or do you just eat them out of the package?
I eat them raw.
Just raw dog it.
Depends. Sometimes I still eat them occasionally. If I'm late for work and I need to, you know, and I'm driving, sometimes Pop-Tarts or granolas are one of the first things I get to. But if I have a preference, I'd rather have them hot.
God, I'm just a dad then, because I just gave me a cup of coffee. I'm good. Coffee and shame in the morning. All right, what else we got now?
Another popular one that's popular with me that no one else I've ever met likes, if I ever ask them about it, is the colored ketchup. You guys remember the colored ketchup? Easy Squirt?
Yeah.
Purple,
green.
Yeah.
Red.
Dead green?
Yeah, purple, red, and green.
Purple, red, and green. No, they had a yellow one. Didn't they have a yellow one?
I don't think they did.
No?
No, I only ever had the purple and green.
Mm. Yeah, I would do green most of the time because as a kid, I loved snot and slime.
So yeah, of course.
I felt like I was putting slime all over my food.
Yeah. I don't remember the taste. I don't remember if I liked them or not, but I remember those a lot, and I remember I always had it.
It tasted just like regular ketchup. It was just colored. But, like, my brothers and my sisters thought it was the grossest thing because it's not, it doesn't look like ketchup. It's gross. Ah, different.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's like, you guys ever heard of this grocery store called Jungle Jim's?
No.
No.
I think they got one in Michigan. They got one down near Dayton, Ohio. It's this international grocery store. It's fucking a beautiful place. I love going there. But, because they got, you know, every type of food you can imagine, and they have individual sections for them. They got a huge beer selection. You can get wine and shit there. But I bought from their Jamaican food section banana ketchup.
Okay.
And it's just ketchup made the exact same process, except instead of tomatoes, it's bananas. It tastes slightly different. It has a little bit of banana flavor to it.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it tastes it's got that vinegar.
Texture the same.
It's got that vinegar flavor to it and everything.
Hmm.
Everyone said it was disgusting, but the taste difference is minuscule. But I think it's just because it's yellow.
A good friend of mine, Nick Cravey, from back home, when we were younger making short films, short little horror movies, we loved the green ketchup because it was the only thing accessible that could be used as ooze. So whenever we were making like creatures that were being brought back to life or a science experiment's gone wrong and we needed the character to like throw up something green, like green ketchup was one of the easiest things to get hold of.
Yeah, that really stinks they don't make that anymore, because I never thought that way when I was a kid, when I was like, oh, this is different. I always like, oh, this is cool. Yeah, it's different. It's cool because it's different. I'm not eating ketchup. I'm eating green ketchup because I'm spunky and ironic. I don't know.
Spunky and ironic.
I don't know
why.
It was
a big flop. It was.
It did not sell.
It did not sell.
But I loved it because they advertised the shit out of it on Nickelodeon.
I think it's because it was didn't look like ketchup, so people were like, it's not ketchup.
All right, well.
Because perception's everything in society.
Well, the truth. They still do it now, and I think if I'm remembering, there were they did it then as well, but there were joke nozzles you could put at the end of them too, and that was like one. It was like this crazy wild hair scientist.
Yeah.
I remember you could buy it. It would sometimes be attached to those, and you could twist it onto the top. So when you poured the ketchup, the green or purple ketchup was coming out of like the scientist's nose.
Oh, that's cool.
Or it was coming out of his ears.
And it had like a different design. It could come out like a design. Because I remember they had stuff like stars or something like that. Or, like,
yeah,
the moon
yeah.
shape, and it came out like that a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's cool.
That's
yeah, remember
cool.
that. Yeah. That was fun.
3D Doritos. You guys remember 3D
Why
Doritos?
Did they get rid of those? Those were amazing.
I never liked them.
Excuse me.
I don't know. There was something very. The texture was very odd, especially when you crunch it and you're just.
Because they were grooved.
Yeah.
That bothered. Like I don't like
that
Lay's
because that was 3D.
Me. Yeah, I know. But I'm saying like that's one of the things I didn't like about it.
My favorite flavor that they haven't even brought back this flavor in the States. You can get the flavor anywhere else besides the States in regular Dorito form. But they had 3D Dorito guacamole.
Hmm.
Oh. God, I get
guacamole from the start.
I could eat that. I get a bag of that.
I felt cheated half the time with 3D Doritos because it's already bad enough that the bag itself is 30% air, so you're just chewing into more air.
Mm.
It was kind of a ploy, I think. It was smart, but I didn't like it.
It was cool because 3D was cool. I enjoyed it. I thought they were great.
It's part of that whole Gen X stuff.
Yeah, no, I thought 3D Doritos were great.
Dunkaroos.
Yeah,
that was a big one.
I remember a little bit of Dunkaroos. I remember every cracker was like a kangaroo, I think.
Kangaroo on a skateboard.
Oh, it was kangaroo on a skateboard.
Yeah.
But I remember like it was like those Cheez-Its things. We had this little tiny packet, and you open it up, and you had like three or four maybe crackers. And then it was a frosting.
It was like a Funfetti frosting.
It was like a Funfetti frosting. I remember that a little bit. I don't remember if I liked it or not. I'm sure I probably did.
I used to really love them because then they also had the Dunkaroos where you could scoop them up with a little stick, and they had little Dunkaroo cookies. They're about I don't know, yay big, maybe the size of a nickel.
Mm-hmm.
But it was the wafers, two wafers, and then it had the icing in the center.
Gotcha. Because the icing was great.
Mm-hmm.
The icing was wonderful. Sometimes I would just throw away the crackers and just suck out the icing.
See, that's interesting. You, because I would do that as a kid with baby bottle pops.
Yeah.
Sometimes I would just toss the sucker and just down the powder.
Right, just straight. fuck the nipple.
I want the substance.
just give me the sugary nipple. Jeez. Anyway, go on.
No, that's it for snacks.
That's it for snacks?
That's, I mean, that's the ones I want to talk about. Oh, Melody Pops, too. I forgot about Melody Pops.
Yeah, the
little flute. Or not flute, little there like, kazoo was, thing.
I mentioned this early before the show, and I... do you guys remember? I can't remember the actual name, but it was essentially a tube full of just liquid, either fruity or sour goo. And I remember it being like a high C flavor. Like there, it came in blue or red. But the controversial thing about it was the tip was rounded, and at the very tip was a nozzle. So when you squeezed,
it looked like,
and that's what they would be commercials of kids like squeezing it and being happy, and then literally wrapping their mouth around the whole thing, going down on it, and sucking out the inner, the inside.
You gotta teach them when they're young, you know?
God.
But I remember had a movie gallery sold them.
They did.
Yeah. And did. I do say, though, I felt weird about going down on the tip of it, so what I would do is I would cut the very top of it off, wrap it in plastic wrap, and then put it in the freezer and let it get real nice and hard, and then scoop it out with a spoon.
You said hard.
Yeah.
they don't sell this anymore, but I have a little bit of a scary story that happened to me. It was these kind of like high C, but they weren't. They were like juice bottle coolers. They're just juice. They're just bottles of juice. You know, like a beer bottle, I would say. But it's a plastic bottle that you squish, you know. And it had this twist off.
They still have those.
They still have them?
Yeah.
Well, I remember the twist off thing, and the cool thing was when you took the twist off thing, you would put the twist off in your mouth and suck off the rest of the juice before you, you know.
Everything's about sucking with these kids.
Yeah, I know, right? I remember I actually swallowed the cap.
You swallowed one?
I swallowed one. It scared the living shit out of me. And my mom she rushed me to the emergency room, and they're like, yeah, he'll pass it. I don't remember if I did or not. It's probably still in there.
There was, speaking of juice, the two juices I remember a lot were, one is Bug Juice.
Yep, Bug Juice is still around.
It is.
Yeah.
And then Barrel Juice is what I always called it.
Oh, the little short, squat ones with the aluminum foil cap?
Yeah.
Yeah, those are still around, too.
Are they really?
Yeah, you get them at, like, Sam's Club and shit.
Wow. Because they were always for sale in our lunch line in elementary school. If you didn't want the school milk, you could get this nice, cool Barrel Juice for a whole 75 cents.
And nobody got the milk.
No.
Like thick milk.
I want sugar water.
Give me that sugar water. Speaking of sugar water, before we get into some fun stuff, I want to talk about some soda.
Oh yeah, yeah.
They brought this one back. I shit myself when they brought it back. But Surge.
Yeah.
Surge. So Mountain Dew. Brrr. Mountain Dew, bad, right? Surge, good.
See, I was a defender of a lesser known that everyone was always about Surge. Mm-hmm. I was a defender of Volt.
Volt, I remember that too.
Which Volt's still around, and Surge is only in those big can forms.
Volt is still around?
Is it still around?
Is it? I thought it was.
I thought it got discontinued. I know Volt was came out when we were in high school.
No,
like we were
Volt. Look it up on Wiki. But I'm telling you, Volt is Surge. I'm telling you, because Surge got discontinued in 2001, 2002, and they turned it into Volt. I swear to God, I could be wrong.
It was released in 2005 and marketed until 2011.
Okay.
Any
connection with Surge? I'm curious.
It was touted as an artificially flavored hybrid energy drink. Coca-Cola was marketing Volt as a combination with the slogan, drinks like a soda, kicks like an energy drink. I remember that.
Yeah.
Volt was a citrus-flavored beverage containing many of the same ingredients as the Coca-Cola beverage, Surge.
All right. So it was Surge, and they just turned it into Volt.
And they got rid of it to reintroduce Mellow Yellow.
Yeah. Oh, interesting.
But nobody likes Mellow Yellow.
I don't like Mellow Yellow.
Nobody likes Mellow Yellow.
I will change it. You guys have to try this, though.
Mm-hmm.
I did mix Mellow Yellow recently, not too long ago, with Dr. Pepper. And I call it my pimp juice. And it is amazing.
You call it pimp juice?
Yeah.
Any alcohol in that?
No, not it's just Mellow Yellow and Dr. Pepper.
No, really? I'm fairly certain you guys did this, too, because I think every kid does it. But when we would go to all-you-can-eat buffets when I was a kid, especially Hometown Buffet or Old Town Buffet, I don't remember which one, they would give you a little cup, and then you have to go get your drink.
Mm-hmm.
We would get every single one of them in a cup, call it the suicide drink.
Yep, and then sometimes I remember some of us would put Warheads or Sour Patches in them, too.
That's fucking extreme.
I know it was. I know it was. It tastes like shit. But no, Surge was a big one for me, and then another big one for me was Pepsi Blue.
Pepsi Blue, I got on the list, yeah. I remember that. I had a, I didn't like it. That was gross.
It was blue raspberry.
But it didn't...
It went flat too quick. It reminds me today of the Voltage, the blue Mountain Dew that's still available. It goes flat in minutes. It's horrible.
Well, see, because I wonder, speaking about that, since we're talking about a new product, about Pepsi Blue as an old product, what do you guys think would be the outcome of Mountain Dew Ice, the new Mountain Dew Ice? Have you guys tried that yet?
I have not tried it.
No.
It's just...
Does it taste like Sierra Mist?
It's Sierra Mist. It does not taste like Mountain Dew Sierra Mist. It just tastes like Mountain Dew. It tastes like Sierra Mist with a Mountain Dew label on it.
Huh.
But it just has a lot of caffeine. It's Sierra Mist with caffeine.
I thought Sierra Mist was caffeinated.
No, Sprite, Sierra Mist, 7-Up, all clear beverages, I can tell.
Lime drinks never really have caffeine.
They don't have caffeine. Okay. But anyway, but Pepsi Blue, I remember. And they brought it back recently, and I'm happy to, because it's my favorite Mountain Dew. They brought back Pitch Black. Pitch Black was one of my favorites.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
I have a 12-pack at home right now.
I know we're kind of like deviating a bit from discontinued, but do you guys remember when Code Red, like,
Code Red, hit the market?
Holy shit.
They had the orange one, too.
Livewire. Livewire. Yeah, Livewire is still around.
Yeah, I never liked any of them.
Fun fact. You guys are not going to guess it. But can you guys guess the movie in 2001 that introduced Code Red a year before it was released to the public? They just hinted at it.
Dude, Where's My Car?
Same actor.
Oh, Ashton Kutcher?
No, the other guy.
Oh, is it Evolution?
Sean William Scott?
Yeah.
Is it Evolution?
No.
American Pie 2?
American Pie 2. It is a scene, I googled it before, it's the scene towards the beginning when they're painting the women's house, way before the lesbian painting scene happened, you know? And Stifler walked in and his hand was covering a bottle and it was red, liquid. And if you pause it, it says Mountain Dew Code Red, and that came out in the summer of 2001, that's when the movie came out. But Code Red didn't come out until in 2002. So was there a way of hinting to the audience who watched the movie?
It's like one of those like, Pixar tie-ins that you get.
So Code Red came out in 2000. Yeah, Code Red was huge. It's not as huge anymore, but Code Red.
I do remember a lot of people liked it. I don't know. It's just, for me, and all the offshoots of the major ones, they just, like Pepsi Clear.
Never had Pepsi Clear. Pepsi Crystal just came back out, didn't it? Is that shit?
No. Oh, Crystal Pepsi?
Yeah, is that bad?
I think it's done now, but they brought it back for a bit, I think.
Okay.
I've never had it.
Never had it?
No.
Okay. So what was your guys' favorite soda growing up? Coke, Pepsi, Mountain Dew?
Well, when I was a kid, Surge was life. I think that's how it was with everybody.
Right. Why? Why? Real quick before you finish,
I can't explain.
It's because of the commercial of the guy screaming, Surge!
Maybe that. Maybe because it made me feel cool. Maybe because it has a nice tang to it.
See, I was the same way as a kid with Brisk, only because the commercials were just so intense.
Yeah, Brisk iced tea, yeah.
Brisk! And then it was always a contributor to Celebrity Deathmatch.
Yes. Oh, Jesus, Celebrity Deathmatch.
So I just, I had to have Brisk. But I went back to Brisk. Probably, they have it at, they have Brisk at Taco Bell, I believe.
Mm-hmm. They have them in the gas stations too now, yeah.
I got one and ugh, no.
It's not the same.
I really like the Brisk raspberry iced tea. Those are really good.
But
Surge, when that discontinued, I went to Diet Pepsi. Huge fan of Diet Pepsi when I was younger.
Diet Pepsi? When you were a kid?
When I was a kid. I was a huge fan of it. It was like the only thing I would drink soda wise.
Really?
But then Dr. Pepper, and now I'm desperately in love with Pibb Extra.
Oh, I was about to mention Mr. Pibb was a big thing for me.
Well, now what brand is Pibb? Because Pibb is clearly Dr. Pepper. Is that an off? Is that
brand,
a Coke?
It's bottled by Coke, I do believe.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nobody's saying Faygo.
I don't like Faygos. That's the cheap stuff.
To what it's contributed to now.
You can get a 3-liter Faygo. You only get 2 liters, Jordan.
I don't know, because I was a horny kid, I was more geared towards Fanta, only because the commercials had those beautiful girls.
Fanta?
Yeah. Mm. Don't you wanna, Fanta?
Oh, yeah! I was always about the yellow colors. I was always about Surge, which... I need to find the marketing guy behind Surge, because that man's a genius, because you got three kids, well, they're now in their late 20s, early 30s, that just are creaming over Surge. So, good job. And also Mountain Dew. Mountain Dew and Surge were my
ones. Again, it's the marketing, man. A lot, you look at Capri Suns aren't anything interesting. They're just juice in a pouch. But the commercials always had kids,
turning into liquid.
Yeah, that, and then like reshaping themselves, and then they're skateboarding or surfing. And
that's
like,
that. That's the commercial. That's that fake commercial you showed me on YouTube when the kids reform together and they're a giant monster eating people.
That was a short film done last year. Yeah,
that's amazing. You ever heard of that?
No.
Yeah, this is literally what I just described it as. It's a Capri Sun commercial. It's a parody, making fun of film, and the kids. You know, I remember this Capri Sun commercial when they just float around in these liquid goo. Well, they come together at the end of every real commercial. Well, in this short film, they came together and there's a giant
puppet monster that's
fucking just
killing all the kids.
Disgusting monster. And it's this brutally violent Kill Bill violent style of just blood everywhere, parents screaming, intestines being ripped out. It's insane. But yeah, no, definitely Surge and Mountain Dew for me. Was there anything else you got besides Pepsi Blue and everything we were talking about?
Nope, not soda. Oh, well, okay. Yeah, I forgot. Okay Soda. Mm. I've never had it. I just did my research.
I've never heard of it.
It is a Coca-Cola product that aggressively, super aggressively targeted young kids in the 90s. It was released in 93. Now, if you guys listening home want to look it up, it's OK Soda. And the whole concept behind it was like, oh, everybody, all the kids are apathetic now, man. You know, these Gen Xers. So if you look at all the marketing material, it's pretty much like, our product's okay. Like, there's better things out there, but like, you know, you just want something okay? Get some soda.
Oh, so trying to play it off like that, that classic, if I don't care, it'll draw more attention.
Yeah.
It's the
ironic
definition
soda.
Of cool in the 90s, where
yeah.
It's like you lean up against the wall and just don't give a shit. People
yeah.
think you're cool.
Being ironic. That's all that it is. That's a very famous saying. Can you sum up the Gen X generation in one word? And it's ironic. And that's exactly what the soda sounds
like.
Isn't
it ironic?
Don't you think? A little too ironic?
That's the only line from the song I know.
I really do think. Because it is like rain on your wedding day. It's like a no smoking sign on your cigarette break.
Free ride when you have already paid.
Anyway.
Yeah, if you want to look up the Google search the images for the cans of OK Soda.
And it's not OK, it is OK.
Period.
Yeah, period. Not an exclamation point, that's too extreme for 1993.
Mm. Okay.
Pearl Jam would have liked OK Soda.
Pearl Jam.
Yeah, because it's not, we're Pearl Jam, we're Pearl Jam.
Yeah, you like us, you
like
know.
Us, you know. Yeah. Our first album's called 10. For no reason.
I'm trying to think of other things.
Have you guys ever had Jolt Cola?
Yeah.
Oh, I remember that.
And we were talking about Orbitz before the show. Yeah. You had that. Was that soda?
I think it was just like carbonated water.
And it was cool because it had the little balls, like the little jelly balls in it.
Yeah,
right?
It looked kind of like a lava lamp a little bit. You could shake it and they would float around.
God, I don't know. Was that even good?
My sister liked them.
I remember I just wanted it because it's different.
I've never had one. My sister liked them. She used to get them when she was younger.
Okay.
Jolt Cola I used to drink because my mom used to work at this drive-through convenience store in town. And when I was able to drive a car, I would drive through in the morning and I would get a Jolt Cola. They were probably the size of as tall, if not taller than this bottle of Powerade I got here. And it's just like ultra caffeinated soda. Tasted, I don't know, closer to Coke than Pepsi, but it didn't taste that good.
I do remember it's Red Label, isn't it?
Red Label. Yeah. It was like when energy drinks became a thing, you know, around that time.
Yeah, yeah.
Jolt Cola kind of came back.
They're not really a thing anymore.
No, not really. They redesigned their bottles to look more like an energy bottle. Like it was aluminum instead
yeah.
of plastic and stuff like that.
Yeah, but the energy drink craze, I think, is dying.
I hate energy drinks. They're,
yeah.
Monster, I think Pink Monster is the only one I like.
I don't drink any energy drinks, especially what happened to me at work like 6 months ago. I've been energy drink free for 6 months, and I would never have one to begin with. I probably have maybe one or two a year, but at work, we have a company that actually supplies us with all the food and stuff there. You know, it's got kind of like a cafeteria style, and I was like, fuck, man, I need a fucking just regular monster. I'm just dragging ass. You know, I've had 3 cups of coffee. I just need a monster. And I popped open the can and I started drinking. I was like, this doesn't taste like monsters. Monsters taste like battery acid. This tastes like something worse than battery acid. So I went to the bathroom and I dumped out, you know, the liquid into the sink to see if there's something wrong with it. Because Monster, if you ever dumped out, kind of like this brownish reddish kind of color to it, regular Monster. There was these black spores coming out of, and I was like, oh, this is a moldy can.
Wow.
This is great. I'm having a great time right now. And the thing about Monster that I hate about all energy drinks, they don't have a damn expiration date on them.
They don't?
No. Because you look at the bottom, everything, it says May that, June this, whatever like that. Everything majority has a fucking thing. That's because I Googled it. Why doesn't have it? Energy drinks are not approved by the FDA, so therefore they don't have to put an expiration date on it.
That's weird.
Interesting.
But it was like, I'm not exaggerating, like little black spores. I've seen mold before. I've seen black mold before. I was like, oh, this is fucking black mold. Oh, this is great.
How much of it did you drink?
I did not drink half. Because I said, I took a sip and I was like, oh, well, it's probably the, you know what I mean? Like, it's going to get better when I continue to drink, right? You know, maybe like a natty daddy. But no, it was not. And I'm sorry to bring that up because it's just the point is like, why is that shit so good? Because it is not approved by the FDA. Plus, who really trusts the FDA anyway? But I'm just saying, because of that, there's no laws on expiration dates. Mm. So that can of Monster probably was 6-7 years old. Probably. And I just, oh my God. So anyway, I'm not an energy guy. I don't like Red Bull. I don't like Monster. I've never tried a Rockstar. Anybody tried a Rockstar?
I've never had a Rockstar. I've had Amps and Monsters and the 5-Hour Energies. I don't like any of them.
5-Hour Energies, that actually work?
Not really.
No different to any other thing that you would take.
All right, so then we talked about cereal. We talked about sodas. What else do we have to talk about?
Fast food.
Oh, thank you.
I only found a few that I remembered.
Mm-hmm.
And then the McLobster roll.
Oh, my God.
I've never had the McLobster roll. I don't.
You can get that in Canada all year round.
Big and Tasty was the one I found that I really remember.
You know why, right?
Because it's recent.
Well, yes, but the advertisements what killed it. I actually remember because when I'm bored, we've all done this, but I YouTubed this random shit.
Tumble down the rabbit hole.
Yeah. There was a documentary all about the failure of the Big and Tasty.
Really?
And the reason why I failed is because the advertisements was kids on screen going, oh, I don't want this burger. This burger's for adults. I want chicken nuggets. And the parents would be like, oh, yeah, Big and Tasty. It was advertised to adults, but McDonald's is advertised to kids. No wonder why it was going to fail. It was the biggest flop in fast food history.
The Big and Tasty was?
Yes.
Wow. I only really remember the Big and Tasty. The Big and Tasty, for people out there who aren't familiar, was McDonald's trying to compete with the Whopper. That's all it was.
Naturally.
But I only remember that because when I was younger, I used to always get the double quarter pounder. That was my meal.
Mm.
At the McDonald's that were around my house, in the towns around my house, that was a number 4. Get number 4, medium.
Yeah.
With the Diet Pepsi, or Diet Coke.
Our McDonald's in Swanton, number 4 is still the double quarter.
Is it?
Yeah.
So we went through a drive-thru one time, and my mom was like, what do you want? And I was like, number 4. She's like, are you sure? And I go, yeah, I want number 4. It's always the same fucking thing. Turns out, they made the number 4 the Big and Tasty. So I got a plain Big and Tasty, which I don't know if you guys can tell. It's pretty gross.
Yeah, just, I mean, like, a Big and Tasty is, it's nothing.
It's just a
quarter pounder
slightly
with
thicker patty with tomato, onion, and lettuce.
And it had actually a thick lettuce. It didn't have, like, McDonald's crappy shredded lettuce. It actually had thick lettuce, like the Angus. The Angus burgers are now,
yeah,
the Big and Tasty. I remember going back a little bit before. I remember the McLean Deluxe.
That's what I was going to bring up, McLean Deluxe.
Which, that was a huge failure.
It makes no sense. The whole selling point of the McLean Deluxe, as the name says, is it's a leaner burger, less fat.
Mm-hmm.
What I write down? It's gone.
I know what it is.
Low-fat burger. It said like it had like 90% less fat than the regular sandwich. But the question then becomes, why do you go to a fast food restaurant to get a shitty burger?
Well, it's not this, that, though. It was the advertisement what killed it, too, because there was a wonderful commercial of, who is the short, fat friend in Seinfeld again? What's his name?
George.
This was before he was famous, and he was in a cartoon for the McLean Deluxe. And why it was so, it was in a styrofoam plate kind of thing.
Oh.
And when he opened it, one side was the patties.
That's the McDLT.
No, it's not. Is it really?
Yeah, that's the McDLT where they had, you know, that popped up in my research.
Oh, is it the McDLT? The
McDLT was just their way of keeping the vegetables cooled and the burger warm.
Okay, so I'm thinking of completely different. So the McLean...
The McLean Deluxe is an actual thing. It's just...
It's just 90%.
It was a regular cheeseburger, just the meat was... Or the burger was not as much meat. That's pretty much how they got around it.
Gotcha.
More filler than actual meat.
You had something else on your list, too, that's interesting to talk about. The time of the supersize.
Time of supersize. I remember... That was a sad day for me when that went away, because I was a fat little kid.
I love my supersize. I don't remember supersize.
You don't remember supersize?
No? Everything is supersized now, isn't it? I go to Wendy's and ask for a medium, and that the damn thing's an extra large.
No, supersize, the best part was only 50 cents more, so, like, you could get... So say your large is the size of that Bud Light can, large fry. They'd be like, would you like to supersize it for 50 cents more? I'd be like, yeah, fucking load me up. They would probably give you a fry that's as big as your Natty Daddy for 50 cents more. Huh. The sodas, same concept. It would be the 12-ouncer. You want to supersize that for 50 cents more? Sure, and they'll give you like a 64-ounce. Well, not 64, but like a 32-ouncer.
Wendy's maybe was more. The biggie size.
Yeah.
Seriously, guys, that's not how it is now. I remember every time you and I go to Wendy's before in the past, I want a medium drink, and it's a fucking extra large.
The drinks are big now, but they were. I remember there was this, the Supersize was so popular back before they discontinued it for that Supersize Me movie came out. I remember watching the news with my dad one time, and they were talking. A car manufacturer was talking about how they are starting to build their cup holders bigger to accommodate for the supersized drinks from McDonald's.
Jeez!
Because fucking everybody had them, and they wouldn't fit. Now, they taper them down, and now they all fit, but they used to just be like a straight up and down kind of...
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Wow.
And that's the impact that it had. And you could get... It was just amazing.
Which, I mean, the number one piece of profit for any fast food place is their soda. It's because they're buying it for pennies on end, and that's why every now at McDonald's, that's why even large is for $1. It's because their soda is like for a penny, maybe 2 pennies, and it's just 99-cent profit every time you get a soda.
Speaking of soda, I just read this, and I want to talk about before we go back to this because it's popped in my head. Do you know that drinking soda actually would automatically make you throw up? But there's only one reason why it doesn't, and that's because of some ingredient that's in it that doesn't make you throw up. Because everything that you're ingesting with soda is absolutely horrible for you. And when you drink a soda, your body's supposed to regurgitate it.
Yeah, have you ever seen a soda fully boiled?
Yeah.
And what it becomes when it solidifies?
Oh, yeah.
But there's something in it.
The brown sludge.
There's just something in it that makes you not throw up.
Hmm.
Find that interesting. But I don't remember supersize.
No. You don't remember? I think the best part about supersize, the supersize food, because it was just larger fries, larger soda. That was about.
So there was no like larger like
burgers weren't larger. No. It was just the French fries and the soda.
Okay.
But what my parents would do is they had four kids, is that they could just get a supersize fry or two supersize fries, and it's cheaper than getting each of us a medium. Mm-hmm. Or a large or whatever.
Yeah.
And we could just split that, and then we would also split sodas when we got home. My mom would pour it in the cups and stuff. But then if you take that away, they introduced the dollar menu to compensate, but it wasn't the same.
It's what's interesting is the whole debacle when Super Size Me came out, and how they forced essentially fast food restaurants to no longer do Super Size, but you could still walk your happy ass into a convenience store and get yourself a big gulp.
Big gulps, huh? All right.
Or the Polar Pop from Circle K.
Yeah, 69 cents for a Polar Pop.
But these things are fucking massive.
I hate those Polar Pops. There's a Circle K down the street from my work, and I go there to get gas or whatever. And they sell them, 69 cents, which is now 79 cents, by the way. They raise it.
What?
79 cents for
fucking
a Polar
inflation.
Pop. I saw that today. I was like, well, fuck this.
This country's
I was gonna
in
get a
shitter, man.
I was going to get a fucking Polar Pop today. And I was like, 79 cents, 10 cents more, fuck you.
It still takes the same dollar to break. But no, I can't do this.
No, I want to keep that 10 cents. But no, it's just, I don't see the advertisement on that. It says, on it, it's going to keep it colder longer. And it's like, it's just styrofoam.
With plastic in it. No, I think you're right.
It's just styrofoam. It's bad advertisement. But hey, 75 cents, 79
but
cents.
But it's just weird where the attention went to.
Yeah.
I mean, granted... McDonald's is geared more towards kids than, say, a Speedway. But,
yeah,
I don't know. It's just interesting to me.
I remember the Pacific Shrimp Tacos from Taco Bell. One of the two failures from that.
How long ago was that? Do you remember?
That was 2002 to 2003.
Was it? Fucking remember those.
No, of course you don't. Google it though.
That might have been when I was in my I only eat McDonald's phase.
And the reason why maybe it was only a few weeks because I remember getting it because I was so excited. But the reason why I failed was two reasons. Because A, it's Taco Bell and seafood just doesn't really make sense. And its spokesperson, who was popular before, that just tanked at that time, was 50 Cent.
Oh, 50 Cent.
50 Cent was the spokesperson for
Pacific. Remember TCBY Treats that was always tied in with Taco Bell?
No.
Taco Bell, would sometimes on occasion, certain locations, would have their own little ice cream section.
Taco Bell?
Yeah, I've heard of that.
It was TCBY Treats, is how I remember it. It's because they also, if you got a certain, I remember the one in the near one of the hometowns next to me, Chiefland. Mm-hmm. You'd go into Taco Bell, you'd have the actual Taco Bell counter. To the side was TCBY Treats, which was ice cream and all kinds of desserts. And if you got a certain dessert, it would come with a Beanie Baby.
That's when Beanie Babies were huge.
Yeah, so I mean, it was one of the places to go. Taco Bell was the place to go to get certain types of Beanie Babies with your ice cream treat.
And speaking of Taco Bell, they had cartoon characters like everybody. McDonald's and Ronald McDonald.
Yeah.
And all those, the purple guy, which I don't anyway. The purple guy at Ronald McDonald's.
Grimace. Is his name.
Whatever he is. The Hamburglar makes sense. Grimace, is that your liver? I don't know what it is.
I always assumed he was in the shape of a chicken nugget.
That's what I assumed.
A purple chicken nugget?
Yeah.
No, why not?
Because, anyway. I mean, he's kind of like a weird rectangle, or weird rounded triangle.
And then you had the Burger King Kids Club.
Yeah.
Which were cartoons, skateboarding, bicyclists, you know, stuff like that. And then you had the Taco Bell dog and cat, who was a pink cat and a blue dog named Nacho Cheese. This was before...
This sounds familiar, but I'm having a hard time picturing it.
This was before the Taco Bell dog.
Chihuahua dog, yeah.
Yeah, this was before the... You get a Taco Bell?
Yeah.
Yeah, this was before that. But I remember Nacho and Cheese loved to sell you on the Mexican pizza.
Oh, I fucking love Mexican pizza.
Taco Bell's Mexican pizza was what they were selling.
I can remember as a kid, now I don't mind, of course I don't mind, but as a kid, I always hated going to Wendy's because Wendy's was one of the few places that didn't have cool toys or they didn't have a mascot.
Wendy's was your parents' fast food joint. Did you find Nacho and Cheese?
Yeah, it was a very, very pixelated image.
Yep, Nacho and Cheese.
Somebody drawing them. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I remember those.
Yeah, Nacho and Cheese.
I used to hate Wendy's when I was younger.
Yeah.
Solely because of the french fries. I thought they had the worst french fries. And then they changed up their recipe a couple years ago. They do like the fresh cut and the sea salt. I fucking love, that's my favorite fast food restaurant.
I was always a skinny kid, believe it or not, at one point in time.
I've seen pictures.
And the reason why that is, my mom swears by, is Wendy's was the only fast food restaurant in our area. I know it's a big country. People do things differently. But Wendy's was the only fast food restaurant in my town where they had a fucking salad bar.
Oh, I remember that.
And where you can make your own salad. Yeah. For some reason, when I was a kid, and I mean a kid, young, I didn't go to Wendy's to get a burger and fries. I always got a fucking salad bar.
Oh, really?
Always got a salad
bar. They had one of the Wendy's in Walpock when I was younger, and I never got it because I never trusted it.
No,
and
it didn't make sense
to me, and I was like, nah.
I don't know why, because as a young kid, burgers and fries just never appealed to me. When I was a kid, I never got, you know, a Big Mac or a McDouble. I don't know what they called them back then, just regular hamburger, I guess. I always get chicken nuggets. Yeah, I don't know why. Hmm. I don't know why I can't explain it, but yeah, every time I went to Wendy's, that was your parents' fast food. Oh, this is where adults go to get burgers and fries. Fuck them. I'm going to Burger King.
Other than burgers and fries, like another big food item for us, especially in the 90s, pizza owned the 90s. Holy shit, pizza commercials.
Pizza motherfucking Hut. What happened to those motherfuckers? That was the greatest goddamn place in the world. Pizza Hut was great.
See, I've never been a fan of Pizza Hut. It always gave me the runs.
It was the marketing again.
It was the marketing. It was it was skateboarding, snowboarding, extreme kids.
Yeah.
Right, who loved Nickelodeon just like I did.
We had in like 5th, 6th, 7th grade and 8th grade too. We had these book clubs. These like not book club, reading goals. Mm-hmm. So
as
a school, everyone had to reach meet the reading goals, and you had your own individual reading goals based on your test and that you took.
And did you have to take individual tests based on the individual book that you read?
Yeah, on the computer.
Yeah.
So if you reached your goals by a certain date or whatever, they would give you like a gift certificate, like a little certificate. As before, gift certificates, but a little certificate. And it was always for Pizza Hut.
Mm-hmm.
And those were just about the only times we ever went to Pizza Hut, is when me or my sisters, my brothers never did. Say they're nerdy wells. We got those gift certificates. But yeah, I don't like Pizza Hut.
No, I don't like Pizza Hut at all. I'm just saying back in the day it was Pizza Hut, movie, or movie Pizza
it was,
Hut.
It was, I mean, the big three I can remember as a kid was Pizza Hut, Domino's, and Little Caesars.
Yeah, like, we never had Domino's until recently up here.
There wasn't a Little Caesars or a Domino's near me.
Really?
Yeah, no. Not up here for...
When I was younger, we had a Pizza Hut in east of Chicago, and then we had local restaurants.
Wow. Yeah, it was Marco's or Pizza Hut for us up here.
It was just, I can, still to this day, like, just the Little Caesars guy's like, pizza.
It was, I was so excited because I remember the pizza guy, and I was like, I really want this pizza, and she's like, it's not around here, and then finally they came down, and I was like, oh, this is not great. But anyway, what is great is I think we've gone on long enough, so we wanted to say thank you to everybody who has downloaded this episode of Podcast, and we hope you enjoyed this whole discussion of our discontinued food products and also some of our childhood loves of foods, and also our little opening segment of the beer challenge. Again, I know I have lost in reality, but I got brother Brandon best friend running to try shitty beer, so it's a win in my book.
I've had all these beers except for the Labatt Blue before.
You never had a Natty Daddy. Nobody's had a Natty
Daddy. That's true. Okay, I've never had a Natty Daddy. I had a Natty Light.
Yeah.
I don't remember how it tastes. That was almost a decade ago.
I wanted to get 4 good beers and then 2 curveballs, which was Labatt and Natty Daddy. But we'll be back next week for another episode of Podpest. Make sure to check us out at movieguyspodcast.com and movieguys.podbean.com. On iTunes, search for us at Movie Guys Podcast. Also on Twitter at Movie Guys Pod and on Facebook, Movie Guys Podcast. So much. But Brother Brandon and best friend Ryan, thank you so much for joining me.
As always, yeah.
And we'll be back next week for another episode. Take care, guys.
See you.
Goodbye, everybody.